do you remember the conversations you had with your father where you tried to reach him, to change him?
Of course. Well, when I saw the bombs in the news, I told him, look, what's going on? You don't have to do this. You should not do this. A lot of innocent people is dying. And he told me, he answered me, look, I didn't invent this. They used this against my family, my beloved ones. And I answered to him, if anybody puts me a bomb, that doesn't allow me to put bombs to everybody. I don't believe in violence. And that's maybe that's why he approached the government and tried to, you know, when he surrendered to La Catedral prison, it was a way of showing the family a little bit of respect. So he wanted to make peace. He wanted to end violence in Colombia. And he surrendered. And my mother was doing the same thing, was just challenging him and asking him, why didn't he stop violence?
How did he react when you challenged him?
Well, he was very respectful, I may say, but...
He wasn't aggressive?
Yeah, he was open to the conversation, but he wasn't willing to change anything. You know, the CIA was after him, the FBI, everybody was after him, and nobody could stop him, neither do I as a 14-year-old kid.
What have you learned yourself?
Well, I learned so much about violence that I became a man of peace, you know, because I don't believe in violence. I know how it can, you know, disappear a country, a whole country. It can change culture. It can change people. Money doesn't buy you happiness or freedom. Even worse, my father's money, at the end, it was for the financing his own death, you know. So it was, we were dying.
In what sense do you mean financing his own death?
Because when my father died, the cartels approached to us and they told us, we are going to recover all the money that we spent killing your father for these last 10 years. So we're going to take everything if you want to stay alive. Say, thank you. Take everything you I have. I just want to live. I don't want anything.